nonagon is a shape with nine sides, whereas a nanagon is the shape of a coffin with an old lady in it.
Here is one of the many, many comments directed at you, Rachel. This is a nice comment from Turtle Jesus. I'm assuming that is the answer to the question, what is the slowest kind of jizz? says about you, Rachel, I would drag my balls through 10 miles of broken glass just to hear her fart through a walkie talkie.
What's incredible is that you were clearly very intelligent, Rachel, but I watch a lot of Countdown, and every week you stand there for 30 seconds with a marker pen and all that paper, and you have never drawn a cock and balls on that. Not well, once.
I was quite artistic, so I'll give it a go.
Go yes. for it.
Well, if you need a live model...
When I draw cock and balls, I draw it from underneath.
You're my favourite guy in the world.
I'll do the sum, and then in the 30 seconds, I'll try. I'll see how far I get with the cock and balls.
How cocky is it to do? I'll get the sum right, then you've got your cock and balls.
We're going to get the work done, and then the fun stuff.
Well, I'm not going to be as committed to you. I'm only doing the cock and balls.
OK, come on, guys.
We're going to go with one big one and five small ones.
One big one. And the five small ones here are 4, 5, 7, 2, 8, and the large one 25, and the target
63
and 392.
392 is the target. Okay, Countdown.
My genitals have come back.
Why is there a 5 and a 4 coming out?
A bit more exciting for me.
If numbers...
OK, what did you get, Stephen? John?
I got 392, and I wrote it down this time.
392, and you wrote it down. John?
I got 392.
392. 392, Rich?
392.
So, Stephen?
2 × 8 × 25.
Would you like it along the shaft?
Yeah, go on.
Rachel, don't neglect the balls.
You're the only person in showbiz that could say that, and I know you say that in bed. Don't neglect the balls.
Go ahead.
2 × 8 × 25.
2 × 8 × 25.
Slowly on the shaft.
Five minus four is one, plus seven is eight. Take that away, and that's 392.
Yeah.
Use the testicles.
Okay. Five minus four is one. Seven plus one is eight. And take it away.
Striking good looks, blonde hair and tight mini dresses, it's safe to say that Rachel's probably killed off more old men than a winter cold snap. Lee and Rob, you get the first pick of the letters.
Yes, thank you. I'll have a letter.
Two types of letter.
Can I just ask, do we guess on this as well, or is it just them?
Have you been living in Britain at all?
Right, we'll have a... Shall we have a vowel?
Yeah, let's do that.
Right, now, what do you think we should do next?
We need a bit of both, don't we?
All right, consonant.
Right.
Yeah.
B.
U, B. Hey, U, B. Lovely.
Oh!
That's a
all right, I'll do all the letters in the next round. You can do all the letters. How about that?
I'm really not bothered about choosing, to be honest.
Well, I am. Can I have a consonant, please, Carol?
Actually, I want to.
Sorry, that's it. Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
W.
W.
Is that it?
A consonant, please.
H.
Oh, I like H's. The vowel one, please. The vowel one.
A vowel. A.
Pardon?
A.
Another vowel, please. Another vowel.
E.
E. Oh. I'll just write that down. I'll be with you in a moment. Right, I've got a word here. I'm trying to work out what letter I want next. I'll have a. I've got it. I'll have an F, please.
An F.
No, an F. I need an F.
You can have a C.
What is it?
Have you not got a monitor?
Oh yeah, we do. We got.
Oh, we look at this. Oh. You're an idiot. I thought that was a little borrower that had got trapped in a shoe.
If you got bored, it was something else on.
It's hard for me to watch you on a screen because usually when I'm doing that, I have to shut the curtains. Oh, this has descended so far.
Okay, Sean, go ahead, pick the letters.
You gonna do it?
No, you can choose. Oh. Vowels and consonants.
I reckon
you can pull it off.
Maybe later. Please, Rich. Thank you, Sarah. Start with you.
You. And another vowel, please.
Oh, God. I.
And another.
O.
And a consonant.
C.
And another consonant, please.
N.
And another.
T.
I'll set the clock off. I got to do sizes. Never get a word. Okay, Sarah?
And another consonant.
John, your turn to pick the letters.
John or the kid, don't mind, I got access to both.
Okay, countdown kid, it's your turn to pick the letters. I feel like I'm indulging a child.
Howdy.
Howdy.
Kid want a consonant.
Kid got N.
Kid want a vowel.
Kid got A.
Consonant as well.
Kid want a consonant.
Kid got K.
Kid having a lot of fun. Kid want another consonant.
D.
Kid want a vowel.
E. Yay!
Kid should have asked for the vowel first. Kid want another vowel.
I.
Kid want a consonant.
G.
Kid need a throat lozenge.
Kid needs a fucking life.
Oh, God.
Kid gon' carry on. Kid want a consonant.
P.
Kid want another vowel.
And kid got E.
OK, your time starts. On to our first numbers round. John, Adam, your turn to pick the numbers.
Go for it.
I didn't feel quite comfortable in that round, as myself.
No, I
feel
I
underachieved.
That. Yeah.
So I think if I could just put this on for a moment.
Bonjour, Jimmy. Je m'appelle l'enfant content.
Well, one of those words you can't say.
Many words I cannot say. Bonjour, on y va.
What are your tips for this one? You have actually have a theory about this, don't you?
Pick a number and then do it again 5 times. Pick a big number.
A big number, please.
Seulement un?
Me?
De la petite.
Six. Quatre. Trois.
This has gone a bit fucking far, hasn't it?
And 25. And the target you can have in English. 528.
Okay. So, John, you're picking the numbers.
I have
Another hat!
Here you go. Hey, you didn't, mate.
Wow, you saw, you're an Australian who's been castrated.
Lady!
That was the case with all of them.
You know what's lovely is this time I can actually talk to you. French, I'm not across, but Australian. Yeah, how's it going, mate? You all right?
Yeah, and all that stuff. I saw a bloody kangaroo before, didn't I?
Did you? Yeah, what'd you do?
Just walk past it. There's loads of them in Australia, isn't there? It's not noteworthy, is it?
What was his name?
Pouchy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I know, Pouchy. He's a good one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hit him with my car! My ute! G'day, Rachel.
You sound like Dame Edna.
Okie dokie. This time I'd like two biggins.
Just because we're on zero, can you do me a favour? Can you stay in character when you do the maths as an Australian, then I might win?
It's actually very offensive. I'm actually quite hurt. Two biggins and four littlins.
No problem.
Stick the four littlins in the pouch of the two biggins.
Sorry, Rachel, before when you put them up, you did the French accent, so I think it's only fair that you do the Australian accent as you put the numbers up.
Six, ten, two, three, 150. And the target, 122.
Lee?
422.
Lee, how did you do it?
Right, you take that 422 at the top. Write that down. Don't touch it with any of the other numbers. I haven't got any faith again, you useless bitch! Giving you your life is when you're alive! Nothing! Sorry, I've been under a lot of stress since she died.
Well, that was it, was it?
I got nothing. Sorry.
Oh, Lee, well, you Lee were writing whole... stuff. You've put minus eight there. 66 there you've got. And 78. Where's that from?
That's when she died.
That makes sense, though, yeah.
Well, this is either going to be Mexican or Chinese.
Either way, it's going to be racist. Oh. Hello, my friend.
Hello!
Still be either.
There was just a moment in his eyes then, I saw it, which went, I really wish I hadn't done this one.
It feels to me this is the only thing on television that makes the Dolmio ads look OK.
Your people are ignorant.
Adam, pick the numbers. I would say John picked the numbers, but we could be here for days. Go on, pick the numbers.
Two bigs and the rest littles, please.
Sure, gringo. Too big. Four.
Oh, yeah. OK, sorry. Here we go. Here comes the Mexican.
Oh, two! Six. Five. Three. 75. 25. 327.
OK, OK. For this episode of Countdown's Countdown Only, the conundrum is worth, and Joe has checked the rule book on this, it's worth 100 points.
Come on.
OK.
Right.
So it's a sudden death situation.
We're willing to go along with a joke, but we'll be livid if we lose. I think you're going to get the conundrum because I can't press my buzzer without fingering your dead nan.
Seriously, but I'm just going to load my nan's dead skin dust off the monitor so I can see the conundrum. Sorry, Nan, I'm just going to move you over there.
Fingers on buses, it's time for today's crucial, worth 100 points...
Come on!
...countdown conundrum.
Sorry, can I just say, this isn't actually the... This isn't the answer, but I'm surrounded by my dry nan and you put damp on coal. I mean, is that... What's that about? You rub it in!
What have you got?
No, hang on, that was...
What have you got?
My damn uncle, he drowned. You can't do
John,
it
John, what have you got?
Is it unclamped?
Let's have a look.
Ah, oh, yes.
So the final scores are...
Wrexham have had the highest ever score on Countdown, 153 points. Congratulations. John Radham. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and to all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night. Rachel's got a first in quantum mechanics from Oxford University, and now she does the numbers on Countdown. It's like using the Large Hadron Collider to heat up soup. Rachel, you hosted a show recently about improving your memory. Have you got any tips for us on how we could improve our memories?
Yeah, so the visual memory is a lot stronger than any other kind of memory. So if you wanted to remember someone's name, say Jimmy, for example,
right,
you could think of something memorable to you. So I'd go maybe Jimmy Riddle, Cockney rhyming slang. So imagine you having a wee, and then you imagine something really prominent about their face that stands out. So you look a little bit like a vampire.
I'm not sure we can all agree on that.
So you could be dressed up as a vampire having a wee, and then I'd remember your name.
I think what you're having there is a sexual fantasy.
Doesn't work with everyone, because Kathy Burke, Burke's a really rude word in Cockney rhyming slang, so you shouldn't go there.
Is it?
Berkeley Hunt.
Oh, is that what it's from?
Yeah. Ah.
And so, what does that rhyme with?
OK, Rachel, you recently hosted a show about improving your memory. Have you got any tips on how we could improve our memory? A polyorchid is the technical term for a man with more than two testicles. Since I hired my new fitness instructor, Diego, I've become a polyorchid. I've got two testicles in the normal place and another two in my mouth. In charge of the numbers, we've got Rachel Riley. Rachel Riley appeared on Strictly, where she proved she's not only nearly as clever as Stephen Hawking, she's almost as good at dancing. Rachel, last time Bill Bailey was on the show, you revealed that you've actually got a bit of a crush on Bill. Do you think you'll be able to sort of keep your emotions in check this evening?
Well, I kind of lost the power of speech last time Bill was on. And as soon as my producer found out he was on again, he actually sent me an email and told me not to disgrace or embarrass myself again. And my mum actually got me Bill tickets for my birthday, so I've got an incentive not to get a restraining order before October.
You've got tickets to see Bill in October?
I'm... Yeah, I've
been about... in a theatre or just in my house? Well, I'll be there.
It's weird because if you saw both their pictures like on the telly and said which one's stalking which,
before we start, me ping's just gone off in the oven, and I've prepared a snack for everybody.
Oh, lovely.
Just in case anybody... I mean, I'll put them down here in case you want one. But don't be too greedy, Jimmy, because, you know, three fingers is enough for anyone.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley.
Yay! Cool.
Rachel is constantly confounding society's outdated sexist attitudes. First on Countdown by being a young, attractive woman who's also excellent at maths, and then on Strictly by being a young, attractive woman who shit at dancing. Quick bonus round to try and break the deadlock. Tonight's prize is the Countdown goalpost. So to win some extra points for your team, you'll have 30 seconds to score as many penalties as you can against the Countdown goalie. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Countdown goalie. Rachel, have you played football before?
Yeah, I was more of an attacking midfielder slash attacker. I wasn't much of a goalie.
You weren't much of a goalie?
No.
OK.
Looks like a keeper to me.
OK, so Sarah and Bob, you're taking penalties for bonus points. OK, yeah, assume the position, you two. Okay. There's a penalty mark over there.
Do we take turns, Jimmy, or is it free-for-all?
No, it's a free-for-all. 1 point for every goal you score. You've got 30 seconds.
Have we been allocated a colour of ball or no?
It's whichever.
So I'm giving too much of a shit here, aren't I?
What are you doing, Sarah?
Just getting them ready. This is what they do in the matches.
Are you going to get a strop if I use any of these balls that you've positioned?
Yeah, they're not yours. Fuck off.
I thought... that be the case.
OK, so your 30 seconds starts now.
Go, Sarah, go.
So the scores are in. Sarah scored 3 goals, Bob scored 5. OK, on with the game. Sean and Bob, your turn to choose the letters.
Go on, Bob, treat yourself. Have fun.
Thank you. Could I have a vowel, a vowel, a vowel?
I'll try. E... A... O.
And 3 consonants, please.
C...
Consonants.
L.
Say again, Bob.
D. Mm.
Another vowel, please.
E.
And 2 more consonants.
Consonants.
It sounds right now.
T.
And R.
Okay, Alex, could you play the clock music in a different style?
Okay, do you want Pedro on sax? Some technically difficult sax.
Okay, no, that'd be great. Okay, your time starts. It took every fibre of my being not to chase Rachel round during that. So, but in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel has appeared on Countdown, The Gadget Show and Strictly. Is there anything Rachel can't do? Yes, dance. Rachel, you seem very calm and collected on this show at all times. Is there anything that really makes you lose your temper?
Just the usual stuff, like animal cruelty or religious persecution, or if someone tries to tell me the numbers answer before I've got it on Countdown.
If someone tells you how to do it before you
do it,
you get
irate. It's most annoying if I'm watching it back at home and then I get it before I get it.
You're saying the only person that gets it before you is you.
She's so smug. Like TV me. She's really annoying.
So you've watched yourself back and you annoy you?
Yeah. Sorry. I'm sorry.
Yeah, you say sorry to yourself.
Yeah.
It's funny you mention that. Because I do love cycling, and these trousers, I might as well show you this, are specifically cycling commuter jeans, which is, they have a fully reinforced padded gusset on them.
Oh,
there.
They do!
Can you see that? which
I can out. Confirm, that is very padded.
Are you wearing Always Ultra? Because it looks like you've got an Always Ultra in it. It looks like...
Can you go rollerblading in those? Yeah.
Do you feel our final letters game, Sean and Bill, your turn to choose?
Okay, vowel, please.
Thank you.
Rachel.
Oh.
Oh. The noise some people make during sex.
Yeah, especially for Joe's mum.
What did you say?
That's especially for your mum.
She says she grunts in the sack.
I think what? She's a fucking bitch.
Now it's kicking off. Now it's fun.
Can I have a consonant, please, and make it sexy?
Yeah.
P.
P.
Operation.
Oh.
Well done on the sexy there. The slightly withered hand look.
P.
Oh, you know sexy. You said make it like a corpse bride.
Zombie.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
You just look drunk.
A. Could I have a... Oh, no, I mean vowel. Sorry.
Oh, yes!
Bah!
Consonant, please.
A moment was originally defined as 1/40th of an hour or 90 seconds. It can be used in phrases such as, would you like to have sex with me? It'll only take a moment. And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel is like a film star. Unfortunately, that film is Rain Man.
I thought it was going to be a dancing joke. I'll take Rain Man, that's fine.
She's also shit at dancing. Fun fact, Susie's not just a lexicographer, she's also the world's leading authority on watching people's eyes glaze over as you talk to them. OK, Susie, what have you been researching recently?
I've been looking at the vocab of sex and relationships in sort of linguistic terms in the 19th century and going back long, long way. I've written a few down because I know you will have heard them quite a lot. Princock.
Yeah, I hear that a lot. What's it?
It's an arrogant fop who makes inappropriate advances. here's one. Witling. A witling is someone who tries to be funny but isn't.
Not very nice to be on the receiving end.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel, you and Susie are good friends. Have you given her any unusual presents?
I did have to give her advance warning once because I ordered her something for her birthday and you couldn't write a note who it was from, so before the husband accidentally opened it, I said, I've sent you a bra. Susie just... I don't know what she packs when she comes to Countdown, but she's always asking for my bras. So I just finally...
In fairness, so am I, Rachel.
I've always got wine!
Now, Catherine, you're with John tonight. Who would be your ideal teammate? I mean, I'm not saying John Richardson's not a dream come true, but who would be your... the best celebrity to be teamed up with on this show?
Ooh, wine.
Rachel Riley to be on my team, and then we could get like some hunk to do the letters.
I'll be free.
We'll get some Dick and Balls up there.
Is that his name? Dick and Balls. Unfortunate name, he'd get bullied at school. Because whenever Ed Balls gets really depressed, he says, well, at least my first name isn't Dickon.
Or Harry. Or Itchy.
Or cancerous.
Yeah. I mean,
cancerous isn't a great first name, even if your surname isn't Balls.
My sister's genuinely just had a baby and named him Dick, like a 1950s spy. And it's great, because when I want to see pictures of him, I'll text my mom and be like, Mom, have you got any dick pics from me? I'll take some dick pics at lunch.
Judge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley. Rachel recently tweeted, there are more lion statues in the world than lions in the wild, and that's scary. But Rachel's determined to do something about it and has recently become the face of a campaign dedicated to smashing up lion statues. OK, the prize the teams will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Stairlift. Okay.
There's always a bit where it stops being fun.
No, I know. We'll make it fun because we'll do it in a sing-song voice.
Okay.
Consonant. L. Let's have another one of those. We've got to focus.
Sing-song didn't last very long, did it?
Bam, please. E. Ooh. I've got a word. Right, we'll continue. Another vowel, please.
U.
I don't like U's.
Me?
No.
Scouse and Winkleman there.
I don't like you.
No, just a letter. Let's have lots of consonants.
Lots of consonants. V.
What?
T.
And another one.
R.
Have you written it down?
What can I offer you?
No, not yet.
Come on, pup.
No, well, she's in the eye line, so every time
She's so blocking.
Use this.
And
limbo. And then, should we have another vowel?
Please don't do that. It's hard enough to focus as it is.
It's not normal.
I think you're the kind of person that can't make a pot noodle, though.
Oh, no, I can't pour stuff. That goes with coordination. We've been through it. We cover this every week.
We don't cover it every week. We occasionally mention Strictly and your appearance on that, and it makes us feel better about our math skills.
Is that the problem? When you're dancing, you're counting.
You're supposed to count when you're dancing.
Yeah, but you're not supposed to add up. One, two, one, two, four, six, eight, eight, eight.
OK, so, Lee and Bob...
vowel. Consonant, vowel. Consonant, vowel, 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 consonant.
A-N. U-S.
Vowel, please.
A.
Consonant, please.
N.
Ha! Come on!
Consonant. Consonant.
S.
Oh,
my God.
Vowel.
E. There you go.
Anus and C. A recent survey's revealed 45% of UK teenagers find maths boring. Well done, 45% of UK teenagers. You are correct. And did you know, for example, World Maths Day is celebrated on the 6th of March by literally no one? It just gets harder and harder. Looking at July.
But then, I want to answer.
To December. Romesh.
Well, Matty.
Yeah, 700.
All right, Johnson.
Yeah, 700.
So. Matty?
Well, you take the 7 and multiply it by 100.
All right, so yeah, 7 times. Poor old Rachel, she's gagging for a hard one. All she gets is... I think you are a disgrace. How could you?